Good evening, students. We are back here with the second lecture of the class 6 science, chapter 1. Food, where does it come from? I hope you have all completed your assignment. There was a question that the definition of food is not given. So the definition of food, as I told in the previous classes, I'm repeating it again. Food can be defined as any substance that can be broken down into simpler forms to produce energy for our daily-to-daily works. Okay, again I'm repeating, any substance that can be broken down into simpler substances to produce energy for our daily-to-daily works. Okay, so before moving on the further chapter, let us recall what we have learned in the previous classes. So just see this. First, we have written what learned what is the necessity of the food. The food is necessary for the for getting energy. Food help us to grow and repair worn out tissue, and food help us to stay healthy and protect our body from diseases, from developing our immune system. Next, we discussed how do we get food. So we get food from both plants and animal. So we have discussed food from plants. So before moving that, how do we get food from the plants? How do the plant get their food? So green plants make their own food in the presence of sunlight using carbon dioxide and water from the soil with the process called photosynthesis, and that's why they were called producers. The extra food is stored in their various parts. Now we eat the different parts of the plants. So what were the parts of the plants we eat? Roots, stems, leaves, flower, fruits, seeds. So in roots, we eat the roots of carrot, radish. Stems, we eat the stems of potato, ginger. Leaves, we eat the stems of leaves of spinach and cabbage. Flowers, we eat flowers of cauliflower and banana. Fruits, so we eat the fruits of pumpkin, ladyfinger, etc. Seeds, we eat the seeds like moong, kidney beans and chickpeas, which are also called pulses, and cereals like wheat and maize, and seeds of cumin and pepper, fenugreek, are used as the spices. We also eat some seeds after sprouting them. Next, food from animals. So we get food from the animals' products such as meat, eggs, honey milk, cheese, butter and curd. Meat, we eat meat of animals such as goat, chicken, fish and prawns. Eggs, we get the eggs from birds such as hens, ducks and geese. These are rich in proteins and vitamins. Honey, we get the honey from the beehives, which are made by the bees by sucking the nectar from the flowers. Next, milk, we get milk from animals such as cow, buffalo, goats and camel. Milk is also called as a complete food because it is rich in calcium, vitamin and protein. Milk is also used to make many other products such as ghee, butter, cheese, paneer, etc., which are also called the dairy products. Paneer is obtained by adding lemon juice in the hot milk. Cheese is prepared by curdling the milk. Cream is obtained from removing the top fatty layer of the milk. Butter is made by churning fresh cream. Ghee is made by heating butter. We can prepare curd at home by adding a small sample of curd in the warm milk. Next, today we will discuss what animals eat. So as we know that animals cannot make their own food, therefore they depend on the plant and other animal for their foods. Animal eat different types of food based on the food they eat. They can be classified as herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. Animals cannot make their food. They depend on other plants and animal for their food, and on the basis of their food habits, they can be classified into herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, scavengers and decomposers. Now one by one we will look at each category. First category comes herbivores, animal that eat only plant and plant products are called herbivores or herbivorous animals. Once again, I am repeating, animal that eat only plants and plant products are called herbivores or herbivorous animals. Examples are cow, buffalo, deer, horse, giraffe, etc. They are called herbivores because the word herbivores is derived from two words, herbi, which means plant, and vore, which means eater. So what are the special characteristics of the herbivores? Plants are not easy to digest. They need to be chewed well to be broken down into simpler substance. Therefore, herbivores like horses and cow have wide teeth at the back of their jaws. The first characteristic is they have wide teeth at the back of their jaws to grind the plant material before it is swallowed. So to swallow the food, they have wide teeth at the back of their jaws to grind the food properly. Next characteristic is herbivores such as cow bring previously swallowed food to the mouth for chewing it thoroughly. This we will learn in the further classes, that how do they bring the food back into their mouth. But just for this topic, we will just remember this fact that they bring back their food again into mouth to be chewed again, because most of the nutrients are not absorbed once in a time. So to absorb them, they need to be brought back into the mouth. Next, herbivores such as butterfly and hummingbird have a special mouth part that help them to suck the nectar from the flower. They have a specially designed mouth that help them to suck nectar from the flower. Like you can see this mouth, they have a special mouth to suck the nectar from the flower. This is a hummingbird which is sucking nectar from the flower. Next, squirrels gnaw neat with the help of a pair of sharp front teeth. Squirrels grow nuts with the help of a pair of sharp front teeth in each jaw. So what we have learned? Herbivores are the animals that eat plant and plant products. Characteristics of the herbivores: they have special white teeth at the back of their jaws to grind the food. Next, they bring back the food again into mouth for chewing it thoroughly. Next, they have special mouth parts that help them to suck the nectar from the flower. Next, squirrels gnaw nuts with the help of pair of sharp front teeth in each jaw. Next, we will learn about carnivores. So carnivores are the animals that eat the flesh of other animals. What are carnivores? Carnivores are the animals that eat the flesh of other animals. Examples are lion, tigers, or owls, eagles, and snake. It is also derived from two words, carni, which means meat, and vore, which means eater. So the animal which eat the flesh of other animals are called the carnivorous animals. Now one by one we will look about each characteristics of the carnivores. Carnivores such as tigers and lions have special pointed teeth. Remember this point. Carnivores such as tigers and lions have special sharp pointed teeth called canines and sharp claws. They also have the powerful jaws to chew their food properly. Next, carnivores such as eagles have curved pointed beak that allow them to tear the flesh. Carnivores, birds such as eagles, have curved pointed beak that allow them to tear their flesh. These birds have sharp claws called talons to help to hunt and catch their prey. What is again? Carnivores such as eagles have curved pointed beaks that allow them to tear their flesh. These birds have sharp claws called talons to hunt and catch their prey. Next, owl. An owl either swallows its prey or tear it down into pieces before swallowing. What does the owl do? Owl swallows its prey or tear down into pieces before swallowing it. Next, snakes. Snakes directly swallow their prey whole. Frog have long sticky tongue that helps to catch their prey. Like you can see in this diagram, what does the frog have? Frog uses its long sticky tongue to catch its prey. What does the fishes do? Fishes such as shark eat smaller fishes. They have several small sharp teeth that help them to cut into flesh of their prey. They have sharp pointed teeth. See, you can see in your books, they have sharp pointed teeth that help them to cut their flesh into smaller pieces. Next category is omnivores. So omnivores are the animals that eat both plant and animal products are called the omnivores. What are omnivores? Omnivores are the animals that eat both plants and animal product. Examples: human, bears, cat, dog. Omnivores is again obtained from two words, omni that means all and vore means eater. Next we will talk about scavengers. Scavengers are the animals that feed on dead animals are called scavengers. Animals that feed on dead animals are called scavengers. They do not hunt animals but eat animals that are already dead. Examples are vultures and jackals. As we have seen that when any organism die, some birds like vultures and animals like jackals feed on the dead bodies of organism. So such animals are called the scavengers. Last, decomposers. Certain living organism that act on dead plants and animal and break them into simpler substances that mix with the soil are called decomposers. So what does the decomposer do? Decomposers feed on dead plants and animal and break them into simpler substances. What does the decomposers do? Decomposers feed on dead plants and animal and break them into smaller pieces that mix with the soil. Fungi and bacteria are the examples of the decomposers. Together with scavengers, decomposers play a very effective role in nature. They help to clean the earth from the dead bodies of plant and animals. So what is the main function of scavengers and decomposers? Decomposers and scavengers play a very important role in cleaning the dead and decaying organic dead bodies. Okay, so I think so you have understood this chapter.